What's up, guys? Today I am making this video in hopes that it reaches the top of DoorDash. Yes, in hopes that it reaches Tony Hsu and his boys. I'm going to need your help in doing that, though. I'm going to need you to share this video across all of social media, Facebook, YouTube, whatever. I need your help. And the reason behind making this video is not to bash DoorDash. I'm not bashing DoorDash. I've been dashing for about a year now. I absolutely love DoorDashing. I truly do. Yeah, it has its issues. No doubt. But there are some sketchy things that are being said across social media about the pay, about the ratings, about deactivations, on assigning deliveries. Some things just seem off kilter. And so you, Tony, as a business owner, I'm thinking that you might want to hear from the people that are actually doing the delivering. I mean, you yourself said that you like to go and do the work that your employees do so that you can identify the problems and then gain a better understanding so you can fix those problems. So my challenge is to you, Tony, is to see things from our level and roll with me on this video. Just give me a few minutes of your time. Just roll with me. See, because when I first started, I was paid $5 per delivery plus tips. It was great. I mean, I was rolling. And I'm sure a whole lot of other dashers were rolling too. And that was less than a year ago. Less than a year ago. And since this new pay implementation, it's hard to conceive on how our payments are calculated. And so I'm just asking for transparency and how we're really getting paid. I'm just asking for transparency and helping us understand how you guys could pay, you know, at the least $1 per delivery. It's just hard to understand. And a lot of us on social media are just at a loss as to this payment system. And it's not just the payment system. The rating system is kind of skewed. If you look at the on-time percentages, they're low, probably across the board. Mine is in the 70s, for goodness sakes. I really just think there are some inaccuracies there. Because I think what's happening is the restaurants are late. So, of course, we're late. And it's being used against us to possibly deactivate us. Okay? Also, customer ratings. If you really think about customer ratings, 5 stars. And if we're getting 4.5 or less in most cases and in most markets, we're being deactivated regardless of our on time, regardless of our acceptance rates, regardless of any of those being superior. People are being deactivated and it's incomprehensible. 4.5 stars will deactivate some people. But if you go on Amazon and you look at 4.5 stars, you see a product that's 4.5 stars, oh, your likelihood of you buying that product is really, really a high probability. 4.5 stars out of 5, that's an A. That's an A minus at the very least. But it's not good enough in the DoorDash system, and it's mind-boggling. Plus, most of those people that rate us, something, their food may not have been on time. The driver was late 1 minute. You know, they may have missed the item, which is understandable. They're going to give us a bad rating because we shouldn't be checking these items, absolutely. But most people that rate are the ones who are unhappy. And so I think those numbers are kind of skewed as well. With the expansion of DoorDash from 600 cities to over 1,600 cities over the next year or so, we are getting deliveries for 20 miles away for $8. Incomprehensible. You want me to travel 20 miles, which will take me about 40 minutes, for $8. Back and forth is 40 miles. That's over a gallon of gas. That's about $4 to $5 in gas. I made $3. You see what I'm saying? Tony, go on rides with us drivers so you can get the true feel of what we're experiencing. That's all I ask. That's all I ask. I won't keep you too much longer, but my final point is there's high turnover in this business. Very high turnover. But as a business owner, would you want to try to maintain those people who give the best effort, those people who show up? We want to try to maintain continuity of drivers. I'm just suggesting, and I know nothing about business, okay? That, I don't know, maybe, and I'm definitely not trying to say, Tony, you need to, that's not my place, but I'm just coming from a driver point of view. Maybe just tweak some things so there is some sustainability. So people can start talking positively in social media, Facebook, and to their friends and family about DoorDash. I mean, it's kind of embarrassing when I tell somebody about DoorDash and they're like, oh, heck no, I got horror stories. And I know that that culture, it needs to change. It definitely needs to change. And you're the one that can make it happen. So I'm just bringing this to you. Again, I know nothing about business. I know every business has a bottom line, and that's the almighty dollar. I get that. And I'm not saying what you guys are doing with the payment system is illegal. I'm definitely not trying to imply that. All I'm trying to ask you is to have a heart and to listen, to hear the voices of the drivers as we voice our concerns, and we hope that our concerns truly matter to you, the owner. You truly do. I know you have a heart for people. I know you know what it's like to have lack in your life. You come from humble beginnings. And so do a lot of your drivers who struggle to make ends meet. I'm just asking you to have a heart and consider these things and maybe just bounce ideas off of your employees and the other leaders of DoorDash. So that's all I'm asking. Don't forget, you guys, spread this video. I will continue to DoorDash. Again, I love DoorDashing. I will continue to give my best effort to make sure customers get A1 service from me. And I hope they receive that same service from you. And let's just go out, give it our best. And I'm hopeful that this will reach Tony's desk. And Tony, if this did reach your desk, I appreciate your time. And thank you very much for your consideration. I'm in all these things in advance. Take care, guys. Take care.